Hey Scrappers, it's Tom from the iScrap app, and today we want to go over our metal of the month, which is iron. Of course, you love iron. It's heavy, the prices can go up and down, they fluctuate, but we want to go over some different grades, so let's do that right now. Now, in front of me, I have three different grades of steel that we want to talk about. Now, steel and iron, while they're very similar, iron ore generally is what you talk about when it's coming out of the earth, and then it goes into all the different products. Here we have a rotor. These rotors are going to come off of cars. They also could be known as brake drums. We see the brake drums coming off of the large trucks. But these rotors are hardened steel, and they're generally a much better grade because of the material and the different manganese and other products that are put inside just to really harden it. So when you get a lot of these rotors, you want to make sure that you keep them separate. One thing you want to look out for, sometimes the brake pads could be attached to them. You want to make sure that you take those off. These generally are one of the higher grades of steel. They're going to be slightly below a grade like Bushlane, but they're going to be much higher than a number one prepared or something along those lines. Next, we have cast iron. How do you know you have cast iron? Well, it's going to be relatively easy to break just by slamming on the ground. You can see how it breaks, and it's generally because it's a real cluster of a lot of different metals that are put into blends, melted together, and then poured into different molds. So cast iron, think of the word cast, casting. It's something that could be done inside of a foundry, poured molten hot steel into these different molds, and it pops itself out relatively quickly and easily. To my right, I have a piece of steel. It's going to go as an unprepared, but that's because of the length of it. When you look at it, it's about 6 feet, 7 feet long, and to get higher prices, you're going to want to have something like this put into the number one prepared pile by cutting it into 4 foot lengths or shorter. Now, these number one prepared items, they could be classified sometimes as a HMS, a heavy melt. There's also P&S, which is prepared and structural, or plate and structural, excuse me. That plate and structural could be coming from something like an oil tank, from buildings, the I-beams, things like that. And the smaller that you have these pieces, 4 feet and under, the more money that you're going to be paid. Now, of course, there are many grades of steel, from light iron to bushlane to silicon bushlane, brake rotors, drums, your autocast, your brake, your old engines. You have torching. Torching could be something like a counterweight off of a forklift that needs to be torched multiple times to have it cut into smaller, more manageable, and shipping worthy pieces. So while there are so many different grades of steel, you really want to be able to look for these things by using the iScrap app's material guide. You're going to be able to see different pictures, different descriptions, and then by working with your local scrap yards, you'll be able to learn about the different grades of steel that they have. There are also things like steel turnings that could have come out of machine shops, but those could be contaminated with water or oil and the like. Scrappers, this is Tom from the iScrap app. We hope that you enjoyed this video on our metal of the month, steel and iron. Until next time, I'll scrap you later.